Good morning and welcome, my dear friends, to Thursday morning prayer. And what a lovely morning it is here in Cumbria. The sun is shining and nature is in revolt with such joy, and the birds are singing, the pheasants are in the garden, the hens are happy and the doves are fluttering. So what more do we need? We have the hundredfold, or do we? Well, let us begin by first welcoming our dear Sister Jane, and of course, Sister Sue and Sister Jan, and those who've not logged in, you're welcome to this place of love. So let us just be still for a moment as we come into the presence of love. The God of many names and the God of none invites our hearts to break bread together in fellowship and to dispel all judgment, all fear, all negativity that emanates from many of the world religions, because so many are rooted and have been groomed to live in fear. Fear of listening to their heart, but following the party line for fear of upsetting the status quo or the magisterium of the church. Today, Christ wants soldiers, emissaries of light, who are willing to step out of their comfort zone and to be ambassadors of peace. So let us now become those ambassadors of peace. I've lit my light this morning and I would like to dedicate it for each one of you, and especially for dear Jane, who's been unwell of late, and pray that the physician of our souls will touch you today. But I also pray for all the members of our beautiful Teo family who battle against many obstacles and yet remain committed and consistent in their humble offering of their heart to God each day. And we pray for the strength that we all need to unite and become closer and become one loving family, and to dispel fear and judgment. We pray for our brothers and sisters of the Christian family, where there's still many who sit in judgment on those who are not Christian. So we light this light to give glory to a loving God, a Father, Mother, God of many names and none. And we give praise this day for all that we have received in the name of love. Amen. And our Thursday morning communion reads, we enter the eternal and infinite garden with reverence to the heavenly Father, Mother, God, the earthly Mother and all the great masters, and reverence to the holy, pure and saving teaching, and reverence to the brotherhood and sisterhood of the elect. Thursday morning, we commune with the angel of water, saying, angel of water, give the water of life to my entire body. As you say this, you contemplate the waters of earth in rain, rivers, lakes, seas, or anywhere, and the currents of the angel of water are left intensifying and directing the circulation of the blood. And we ask the angel of water to send water to southern Sudan, the Yemen, and the Horn of Africa, where many are dying of thirst, where they have no crops. They've had no rain for a very long time. So we pray that the angel of water will share some of our water with the children of God, our brothers and sisters. Amen. And now, I was guided earlier on to read some beautiful prayers from one of our hermit sisters in New York, Sister Allison, who works with female prisoners. And Allison has been a member for 6 years now, but does live the hermitic life with no internet access. She refuses to have any contact with anything electrical. I don't blame her. And these are the prayers she shared with me then, and I'm guided to share them with you now. And the first prayer is from the Hindu tradition. Peace be the earth, peaceful the ether, peaceful heaven. Peaceful the waters, peaceful the herbs, peaceful the trees. May all gods bring me peace. May there be peace through these invocations of peace. With these invocations of peace, which appease everything, I render peaceful whatever here is terrible, whatever here is cruel, whatever here is sinful. Let it become auspicious, let everything be beneficial to us. And from the Buddhist tradition, from the Metta Sutta, we read, this is what should be done by one who is skilled in goodness and who knows the path of peace. Wishing in gladness and in safety, may all beings be at ease, whatever living beings there may be, whether they are weak or strong, omitting none, the great or the mighty, medium, short or small, the seen and the unseen, those living near and far away, those born and to be born, may all beings be at ease. Even as a mother protects with her life her child, her only child, so with a boundless heart should one cherish all living beings, radiating kindness over the entire world, spreading upwards to the skies. And from the Christian tradition, from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 9, and from the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 6, verses 27 to 31, we read, blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be known as the children of God. But I say to you that here, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, pray for those who abuse you, to those who strike you on the cheek, offer the other also. And from those who take away your cloak, do not withhold your coat as well. Give to everyone who asks from you, and of those who take away your goods, do not ask them again. And as you wish that others would do to you, do so to them. And finally, from the Muslim tradition, from the Quran, 8 verse 61, in the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, praise be to the Lord of the universe, who has created us and made us into tribes and nations, that we may know each other, not that we may despise each other, as it is written in the Holy Quran, if the enemy inclines towards peace, do thou also incline towards peace and trust in God. For the Lord is the one that heareth and knoweth all things. Aren't they lovely? So let us now, my dear friends, reflect on some of those prayers. Were they speaking to your heart? And if they were or are, honor them, bless them. And now our hymn for today is from Sing Your Faith from the Unitarian Chapel's hymn book. And it's hymn number 16. Captive voices cry for freedom. Captive voices cry for freedom. Arms pull bars that will not bend. Liberty, our priceless treasure, we will cherish and defend. Free to doubt and free to question, free to seek and free to find. Let us celebrate our freedom, free in spirit, free in mind. Free our minds from narrow thinking. Free our hearts from prejudice. Fill our minds with hope and reason. Fill our hearts with joy and peace. Free from bigotry and anger, free from ignorance and fear. Humankind heed freedom's challenge. Speak, O Lord, and make us hear. Free all troubled minds from torment. Bring them comfort and repose. Grant us also such a freedom when our lives draw to their close. Free from fear of separation, unenlightened creeds proclaim, universal destination, God of love, from whom we came. Beautiful. And that was written by Jonathan Feast, who died in 1994. Oh, wow. This beautiful hymn book, the words are so beautiful and they speak to the heart. It is a wonderful family, the Unitarians. I have so much joy when I join them for fellowship on a Sunday morning in Kendal. They're so non-judgmental, all embracing, all encompassing, and they really do make you feel welcome and loved. So let us do this today by welcoming all faiths and none to this table of love. From Psalms now, I've been guided to pick it up and just open it at random. And here we go. Psalm 100. Break forth into exclamations of joy and gladness, you who serve the Lord. God is not dead. He is ever our God. He made us, we belong to him. We are his sons and servants, and his love for us never runs out. His care and concern for us will go on forever. Let the world see our manifestations of joy. Let us lift up our voices in songs of praise and surrender our lives as perpetual offerings of thanksgiving. Let us bless his name forever. And yesterday, whilst I had a teaching session with Sister Jackie as part of her formation before she takes her vows on the Feast of St. Francis, we were reflecting on Mansion 3 of entering the castle by the great Teresa of Avila. And there were various sections that really gripped our hearts, but one, I'm just going to share some of the words. And the section is titled A Moment of Contemplation. Again and again, you feel the mystery. Surrender is the ultimate test of the human experience. What are you actually surrendering to? How is a prayer of surrender supposed to change your life? What does it feel like to abandon yourself into the mystical arms of the divine? Christ consciousness is a universal force, the energy of spiritual evolution, the realization within the individual soul that power, wisdom, and love must be balanced in the mind. With Christ consciousness, you experience the unity of all the universe, yourself as part of a greater awakening to God, as the universe and the universe as God. Christ consciousness means that you empty yourself of ego so that the Spirit can come in. As Jesus said, empty thyself, and I shall fill thee. This is the consciousness of the third eye, the spiritual eye, which identifies the vision of the inner mind and receives information from higher sources. This is the consciousness you want to embrace in your third mansion, a consciousness that surpasses the rational mind. In surrendering to God, you enter a state of consciousness in which you engage fully in your life. You are fearless, full of faith, and possessed by an active mystical purpose. You live in the present moment. You follow guidance, releasing your expectations of what the outcome will be. You live with great faith, but continue your devotion to inner work and evicting reptiles. Abraham, the Buddha, Jesus, and Muhammad, and many others underwent profound transformations upon complete release of their right to direct their lives. When they gave up their illusions that they had a choice to follow or not to follow higher divine directives, your surrender tells God that you are ready for experiences that few others would understand and that you yourself may not understand. How much of your life do you really understand anyway? Experiences that are not of this world are difficult to describe with the language of reason, but you too may have these experiences and feel how they displace the lesser tensions, fears, and illusions of life. Having mystical experiences, moments of quietude and illumination has only enhanced my life, not detracted from it. As I wrestle with my journey through the castle, I would rather be swept away into the embrace of a divine vision than left behind with those who wonder whether there is a God, whether their life choices matter. It fills me with great contentment to know that I do matter, and you matter, and each prayer matters, and I delight in surrendering to the truth. I have read this book, I don't know how many times, in nurturing our new monastics over the last 8-9 years. And each time I read this book, I find nuggets of spiritual delight that just lifts you completely and fills you with such respect and love for the universe, for the divine, and all faiths. And interestingly, Sister Olivia used to run weekend workshops in London for large groups of Sikh and Hindu women. And guess what the subject was? Entering the Castle by Teresa of Avila. So it's not a book for Catholics. It's a book for every child of God who has surrendered their heart and wishes to embrace this journey of love. Because in the seventh mansion, you're shown tools where you actually experience divine orgasm, divine intimacy with the cosmic Christ. And the Hindu and Sikh women would go and tell their friends. So poor Olivia literally was swamped with so many requests that she was doing it twice a month for best part of 4 years. So this book is an important part of the formation of all our members because it gives them the tools to explore their relationship with the divine. So let us give thanks to God for the gift that we have all been given. The gift of love, the gift of faith, the gift of trust, the gifts of inner knowing, the gifts of total surrender of your heart of your life, of your humanity, of your visions and your dreams, and surrendering them to your highest power. So we pray this morning for a fresh outpouring of God's Holy Spirit, and I'm guided to intone the Tibetan bells. Come, Spirit of God, fill each one of us here with your wisdom, your insight, and your joy. Breathe on all of us here, O breath of God. Fill us with life anew, that we might love what thou dost love and do what thou wouldst do. Breathe on Sue, O breath of God. Fill her with life anew, that she might love what thou dost love and do what thou wouldst do. Breathe on Jan, O breath of God. Fill her with life anew, that she might love what thou dost love and do what thou wouldst do. Breathe on Jane, O breath of God. Fill her with life anew, that she might love what thou dost love and do what thou wouldst do. Breathe on all here not logged in, and those who will watch this recording, O breath of God. Fill them with life anew, that they might love what thou dost love and do what thou wouldst do. Father, Mother God, we come from many traditions, but we come with one heart, a heart that is infused by your love. Implant within each one of us here the seed never to lose hope when all around us seems hopeless, never to engage in fear, to protect ourselves with your love from those who are angry, from those who are deceitful and cunning, and those who are what we call vampires, who want us to rescue them rather than be empowered to take back their power and surrender to love. Amen. We come to our intercessions where we pray for each other. And yes, we pray for God's healing strength for all gathered here, for all the beautiful members of our community, many of whom are taken to the pits of hell and to undergo the dark night of the soul, not once or twice, but many times, where they are left feeling bereft of the very one they've given their life to. And then on the 11th second of the 11th minute of the 11th hour, they experience the hand of Christ. And once they touch that hand, all becomes well. And we are given the strength to bless what we're going through, to name it and release it to God and leave it with God. So this morning we pray for the many, many kind hearts that email us for prayer, whose intentions are in this book. And we give them now to God and we say, Lord God, you know your children better than we do. Thank you for taking care of them and their needs this morning. And we pray especially for Jane. Lord, you know Jane better than any of us. and you know her needs even better than Jane. So we thank you for laying your hand on all those areas that need your healing touch today. For Sue and her friend Paul and his son Ben, who was sectioned recently, we pray for them. For Jan and her dear partner John and all their family and the great work they do in St. Helens in shepherding your vulnerable children and protecting them from being exploited. We ask your blessing on Nancy and her ministrations to the poorest of the poor in Mexico from our meager pension. We pray for Sister Jackie and for her family and her granddaughter. And we thank you, Lord, that Jackie is now agreeing to support me in mentoring two new members into our community, Sister Laurie in Oklahoma and Sister Dawn in Oregon. And we remember also Brother Matthew, Brother Brian, and Brother Liam, Brother Rob, Brother Paul and Murray. We remember our friend Sister Jane in Ormskirk and Brother Ron in Liverpool and his dad who had a stroke. We remember dear Olivia, who's getting stronger each day, and for dear Sister Diane and her daughter Kelly, whose husband Jonathan was also sectioned around the time that Ben was. We pray for our beautiful sister, Miriam, a hermit in New Zealand. We remember our dear Sister Buffy in New York State. We remember Sister Caroline Burt on the Isle of Wight and our Franciscan sister of Winnipeg, dear Sister, Corazon de los Santos and her beautiful family. And we remember the many who've asked our prayer, and we pray especially for all our friends on social media, not forgetting dear Brother Skip and Thomas Aquinas Q on Google. And we pray finally for all our religious leaders to unite and pray that they'll be guided by Spirit to return to Assisi and rebuild the center of peace that Pope Benedict closed down, that was established by Pope John Paul II. And we pray for all our politicians and statespeople around the world. We pray for universal peace and that all faiths will respect one another and embrace the divine in each other. So let us now, for a moment, bring to our God of many names and none our own personal requests and intentions. And be aware that Christ is here. You know he's here. So let us be truthful to Christ and share with him what's really weighing heavy on our heart. I pray for my family in Ireland, and I give thanks for all your prayers for my brother Shay, who's doing really well. But I pray for those who have no one to pray for them, the homeless, the unemployed, those living and depending on food banks. I pray for the marginalized in our society. I pray for those who are struggling in mind, in body and spirit, for those who are stigmatized because of their illness, be it mental health, be it physical, emotional, psychological, even spiritual. I pray for the ones who've been forgotten, but they're never forgotten in the eyes of God, because God touches your heart and mine to be the hands and the feet and the beating heart of Christ, and to bring that compassion to them, to bring God's love to them, as Jane did to the young couple she met many, many weeks ago, who are homeless. And now we pray with Jan for myself. Thank you. I do need prayer. Thank you. And for Murray and for dear brother Harry. He must be doing well, because he only gets in touch when he's poorly. So we thank God for Harry and for Rob, Paul, and wonderful. So let us now pray the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, Mother God, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give to all of us here today our daily bread. Forgive us the times when we thought we knew better than you, when we allowed our ego go off on a tangent, when we found it in our heart to forgive ourselves and those who deeply wronged us, who deceived us. Lead us not astray, but protect us from those negative forces that seek to alienate our hearts from your heart of love. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. And our closing prayer, I've opened it, I'm going to close it again and open it at random. Okay. In Psalm 63, verse 7, I sing for joy in the shadow of your protecting wings and from the seek. Even if I have gone astray, I am thy child, O God. Thou art my father and my mother. From the Christian, this son of mine was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found. And from the Zoroastrian Yasna, we say, we pray for homeless people throughout the world, for exiles and asylum seekers, people whose spiritual journey leads them far from home, wanderers who cannot find rest, and those who have shown us kindness and made us welcome. So may we be like those making the world refresh towards perfection. May Ahura Mazda, Lord of Light, help us and guide our efforts through truth. For a thinking man is where wisdom is at home. And finally, from the Sikh, even if I have gone astray, I am thy child, O God. Thou art my father and mother. So go in peace to love and to serve our God Goddess. And as I blow out this light, I give thanks to God for your gift of presence here, for your friendship, for your love, and for your prayers. And in exchange, I thank the Christ for touching your hearts as he promised he would. Amen. And together we say Namaste, Shalom, Inshallah, Pax et Bonum, OmShanti, Solo di Caritas, Salam Aleikum, and may the peace of all that is sacred to you reawaken in your heart today that you are a beloved of God. Amen. If it's your bedtime, sleep well. If not, I pray you have a lovely day. Till we meet again, God bless, and thank you for being here. Amen.